This presentation was basically prepared by Shiny. We had helped her to prepare this. So we are going to talk about the basic troubleshooting that every nurse is going to face during the application of the Paxman. Okay, so can you go to the next slide, please? Okay, so this is how we are going to attach the coolant lines and disconnect the coolant lines. Now, if you can you if you can everyone can see on the side of the cap and on the side of the patient tubings, there is one male and female connectors. They have to be inserted only in one way, and you have to hear a distinct click sound to ensure proper connections of the cap. And for disconnection also, you have to press the white button very gently and effortlessly. The connectors will come out of the main connections and you can disconnect the lines. Can you go to the next slide, please? Okay, this is how the cap is to be applied and it is how to be connected. Now, what all problems you are going to find during this application of the cap is, like we showed you during the short demonstration, either the cap is loose. If the cap is loose, we have to ensure that we check the right size of the cap which is to be taken. Once the cap is applied, there could be a possibility that the scalp is not uniform. If it is not uniform, then we apply a lot of gauze pieces in between the silicone cap and the insulation cap to ensure a proper connection between or conduction of the heat between the silicone cap and the scalp. Okay, can you go to the next slide, please? Now, I want to show you that these are the minor problems that you will see during the fitting of the cap. If you try to fit the cap very tightly, sometimes the rivet goes and hits the cap and it causes minor leakage, which are not very visible. But eventually, a lot of liquid is going to leak out and it is going to make the patient completely drenched with the coolant. So you can see, and there is a, if you see in the medium cap, you can also see the serial number of the cap. So you have to ensure and you have to note and keep the serial numbers copied and placed in a safe place so that we can address the problems. I want to ensure that there is no kink in the cap. You can see in the last image on the right bottom side corner that there is a kink in the cap, which the way it has been placed. If there is going to be a kink in the cap, it is going to tear off from the junction where the cap is connected to the silicone cables, and that is going to create a problem in the long run. Repeatedly, kinks in the cap makes the tubing very, very vulnerable to cracks. Can you go to the next slide? Now, once we saw in one of the hospitals, that is in HCG Nashik, the patient started walking when she wanted to go to the washroom without getting the cap disconnected. Eventually, what happened was the cap got stretched and the tubings got stretched and the tubings got inflated and it caused a balloon-like structure to form at the edge of the cap, and eventually the gap burst. Okay, so you have to ensure that the tubings are not very much stretched. The tubings has to be loose and the patient has to feel comfortable. The, neither the cap should be stretched, neither the tubings on the machine side should be stretched. If such a bubble happens, I request you to kindly switch off the machine. Call the engineer immediately and kindly drain the entire tank. There is a drainage kit provided. Drain the entire tank. Start the machine once again so that the bulge disappears. Call the engineer and kindly decommission the machine till the time engineer resolves the problem. Go next. I want to play the video here. Go back. I want you to play the video here, please.
Yes, sir. Just a second. Just a second.
Now you can see that if the rivet goes and hits the cap, there is a small kind of a shower which comes out, and you can see the cap is leaking continuously. So we do not want this kind of situation to arise. That is why we put gauze pieces in between the rivets and the silicon caps. Go next. There is a definite rupture of the tubing at the junction of the cap and the silicon tubings. This has happened due to heavy kinking of the caps. So kindly, whenever the patient is sleeping, there is a possibility that the patient is uneasy. So she is because she is feeling a lot of cold on her head. She is going to move from right side to left side, whichever, and she is going to wake up and get up and sleep again. The nurses have to continuously watch so that there is no kink in the cap, as what is shown on the right side. If the kink on the cap is there, or if the tubing is taken from the, it is flipped on the cranial side, it is going to cause a heavy kink. This is going to stop the flow to the cap as well as rupture the cap, rupture the tubings as well, probably. We do not want this situation to occur. So I am requesting all the nurses, whoever is watching, and all the doctors, whoever is watching, that they have to instruct the nurses to continuously watch the patient and instruct the patient to avoid any kind of kink at whichever point in the tube. This is my humble request. Go next. Now, as you can see, once it is ruptured, this is on the left side, the tubing has ruptured, the balloon which was there. Yeah, kindly take the mouse up near the thumb. Yes, the second thumb below. Yeah, so that side you can see the tubing has ruptured and the connector is split open. And the entire coolant has leaked out. When such a thing happens, kindly switch off the machine. Switch off the machine and call the engineer. Do not switch on the machine, or whatever the coolant is there inside the machine is going to all be pumped out of the machine. Please help us and do not switch on the machine, and kindly call the engineer. This is in the tubing, yeah, where the mouse is. Near the thumb, you can see, yeah, that is the tubing which is ruptured. Yeah, that one. And on the right side, you can see the cap is ruptured and it has caused a massive leak in the cap. All right. Go next. So this is the screen that you will see. Now, once you start this screen, you can see that on both the sides, there are stage one, stage two, stage three. Many a times we get a lot of call from nurses who ask us that we have already completed the pre-medication, now how to proceed further. Or during the pre-medication or during the chemotherapy, there was a power failure and the machine was switched off. No problem. In such a thing, if it happens, you can again start from stage two, continue till the time the entire chemotherapy is completed. And then you can go to stage three automatically. Now, many a times what happens is they have had a power failure when stage two was completed, and they were going after the post cooling period. Doesn't matter if there is no timer or anything on stage three, you can please proceed forward. Keep it on for as long as possible. The main idea is to keep the scalp cooled. Forget all the timers, forget all that. And if a power failure occurs and it is going to be long, take ice packs and put it on the scalp. Go next. Now, in one of the places, we had seen that the chemotherapy drug had spilled on the screen. So we got a complaint that saying that the screen has got a black blob on the screen. And on the right side also, you can see on the above the word Paxman, there is a lot of blackening in the area on the top corner. Yeah, that corner. Yes. So what happens is you have to protect. This is a touch screen. Okay. So it has got an active inputs available. You should not allow any kind of liquids to be spilled on the screen. Again, if such a thing happens, it is important that you decommission the machine and call the engineer. Okay, and you have to to protect the screen, what you could do is you already have some kind of face shields available with you. Either you can use the face shield or you can use any plastic or any kind of sterile drape or something that you can apply, and you can protect the screen if you are going to have chemotherapy going to be dripping on the machine. Kindly ensure that no liquid spills on the machine. The machine is sensitive, and if there is any spillage on the machine or electronics, it is going to get damaged. Go next. You can see the clearly you can see the liquid being spilled on the screen. You can see the on the right side, you can see this. Can you see my screen? Okay, can you move the mouse please on the right side? On the right side, yeah, you can see those water droplets coming down on the screen. Yeah, that those ones. So kindly ensure that there is no liquid which is falling on the screen. Go next. Okay, whenever the coolant is low, it will give you on the left side, it is going to first give you an alarm, low coolant, please top up. But it will allow the cooling to happen. So you can complete your chemotherapy cycles, you can do all the necessary treatment and then call the engineer. Or even during chemotherapy, if the nurses are trained to top it up, you should top up the coolant. On the right side, sometimes when the coolant is empty and you are starting the machine for the first time, allow the system to cool till the time the coolant temperature, which is shown on the top side of the screen, okay, it has to cool down to -4 degrees centigrade. Now when you see this on the right side of the screen, where you can see above V2.0.5, that is the version of the software, you can see it is showing 131 degree centigrade. If it is showing you 131 degree centigrade, we are definitely not in a desert. We are definitely not in some area which is on the Venus or something. So we are 100% sure that the thermistor is fired. When the thermistor is fired, okay, there is a question. I'll answer that question a little later. When the thermistor goes bad, it is going to show you a temperature 131 degrees centigrade. Can I answer your question, Dr. Mega? Now? Yes, we have to apply water before the conditioner if possible. If there is no water applied, but if the conditioner is completely properly applied, then we don't require the water, but it is always better that water and conditioner combination is always better so that the scalp is effectively cooled. Have I answered your question? Dr. Mega, have I answered your question?
Jigish, can we take the questions after you complete your presentation, please?
Okay, go next on the next screen, please. We have seen that sometimes there is a possibility that the biomedical engineer opens the system and then does the check. And if during the check, if there is liquid spillage into the system, then it is going to cause a massive short circuit. We request you do not open the machine till the time Paxman engineer arrives on site. Go next. Yeah. So we are through. These are the problems we have faced.